Lustbottom the Fifth has joined the Dawn Guard, and is now a vampire hunter. A decision made after getting ambushed for the 10th time by vampires while minding his own business.
What? Okay, I'm gonna become a vampire hunter.
In addition, an ally has joined Lustbottom on his adventures. Gorath, the Argonian battle mage that only knows one spell.
Get him, Gor, get him! Get him, Gor, get him!
Together, they went to Fort Dawnguard and joined the ranks of the Vampire Hunters. And since it's a Bethesda game, the Vampire Hunters immediately trusted them, and instantly sent them on a top-secret mission to steal an important artifact from the vampires. But it turned out that the powerful artifact was in fact, a vampire lady that had been sealed away with an Elder Scroll. Her name is Serana. And since it's a Bethesda game, she immediately trusts us and they immediately trust her and escort her back to her vampire father's evil lair. And to say once again, he's a total dick.
Ah, if only your traitor mother were here. I would let her watch this reunion before putting her head
on. Can I kill this guy?
Then, they handed her, and the Elder Scroll over to him. Evil vampire guy turned into a Teletubby, and offered to make Lustbottom into a vampire. Lustbottom said no.
God, how ugly.
And then went back to Fort Dawnguard to inform the vampire hunters of the news. Luckily for him, being a vampire hunter is sort of like being a police officer. No matter how terrible you are at the job, it's impossible to get fired.
They what? And you didn't stop them? You didn't secure the scroll?
Now that we've gotten caught up, Lustbottom the Fifth was basically promoted, and was asked to find two previous members of the Dawn Guard, and bring them back into the ranks. After that, Lustbottom the Fifth enchanted his crossbow with fire damage and named it, the Flamin' Hot Cheeto Launcher. Just thought you should know that.
Flamin' Hot Cheeto Launcher. Craft it. Who the hell is this guy?
So then, Bethesda writing happened, and Serana showed up at Fort Dawnguard by herself, with the Elder Scroll. Because for some reason, her father didn't take it when she was brought back the first time. Even though he was searching for it for like, 100 years or something.
Okay.
You probably weren't expecting to see me again.
What are you doing here?
I'd rather not be here either, but I needed to talk to you. I'm guessing you figured this part out already,
yes.
But my father's not exactly a good person.
Yeah.
Even by vampire standards.
Yep.
He stumbled onto this obscure prophecy and just kind of lost himself in it.
Mm-hmm.
The prophecy said that vampires would no longer need to fear the sun. For someone who fancied himself as vampire royalty, that's pretty seductive. So, in case you didn't notice the giant thing on my back, I have the Elder Scroll with me. Whatever it says, it will have something that can help us stop my father.
Okay.
But of course, neither of us can read it.
Who can?
Well, the Moth Priests are the only ones I've heard of who can do it. They spend years preparing before they start reading them. Not that it helps us anyway, because they're all half a continent away. In Cyrodiil.
Mm-hmm. Some Imperial scholar arrived in Skyrim a few days ago.
Oh, that's convenient.
I was staking out the road when I saw him pass by.
That's even more convenient.
That's your Moth Priest.
Well, That was all pretty convenient. Lustbottom the Fifth went and brought back the Moth Priest so he could read the Elder Scroll and find out the Vampire Guy's prophecy, and I'll just keep this one short. The dude reads the Elder Scroll, says something about Oriel's bow.
I know this weapon. It is Oriel's bow.
And then says you need to find two other Elder Scrolls in order to get the full prophecy. What a ripoff.
We must have the other two scrolls. I must rest now.
If you think this has all been going smoothly so far, you just jinxed it. Bethesda writing kicks in, and Lustbottom the Fifth deduces that Serana's mother has the other Elder Scroll, and that she must be hiding inside the evil vampire dude's lair, right under his nose.
In Castle Volkir?
Wait, that almost makes sense. There's a courtyard in the castle. I used to help her tend a garden there. All of the ingredients for our potions came from there. She used to say that my father couldn't stand the place, too peaceful.
So then, Serana turns into a dick and says this.
Let's go to the castle's secret entrance.
I don't take just anyone into the secret parts of the place I grew up. Get rid of this interloper and you and I can be on our way.
Wait, what?
I'll wait for you at the dock.
Wait, what? She wasn't talking about Gore, was she?
She was.
Okay. Can I go back to my house and have Gore wait for me at the house? Why did she call you an what the fuck? Serena's forehead is almost as big as Gore's pecs. Jesus Christ.
So, for some reason, Serana doesn't want Gorath to come help find her mom. This is an issue, because Gorath was created using Lustbottom's godification powers, and does not behave like a typical Skyrim companion. Because of that, this might end up happening if we leave Gorath at home.
Alright, no, but seriously, unless you install an advanced follower commands mod or something, if you tell Gore to stop following at your house, I think he'll just walk away into the wilderness, probably never to be found again. Maybe install the mod after getting home, before the next stream, then you can leave Gore there. I think this one would do it, since it allows home assignment. Well, I think I have to install a mod.
So, Lustbottom quickly installed the mod, and went back in-game. The key word here is quickly. He didn't really read all the features the mod included, so I'm just gonna let you guess what happens next.
Alright, let's see what we can do with Gore now. Follow me, I need your help.
We are in this together, yes?
Yeah. Why? Why did you take your shirt off? I'm not tweaking you, Gore. Put a shirt on and then I'll tweak your options. Fuck. Yo. Oh my god. Oh my god. Do it, you coward. Do the snake. Do that. That sounds the least. I was wondering
When I installed this, I was wondering why it took so long to install, because I was just like, it should just add options for my NPCs to just tell them to stay in a house. Why is this mod so big? Why is it taking so long to install? I'm gonna get a fucking headache. Death to all apples with the 8-month resub. This stream is now for mature audiences. Viewer discretion is advised. Did my game just fucking crash?
May the hist guide us.
Oh no. Oh, what is this mod? Amazing follower tweaks. Why is this mod horny? Hold on a second. I need to figure this out. Actions. Give me some sugar.
You better be dancing when this goes through, so help me God.
Oh God, hold on.
Pump up the jam, pump it up, while your feet are stumping, and the jam is pumping, look ahead, the crowd is jumping, pump it up.
Hands in front. Meditate. Warm your hands. Lie down. Rotate.
To guide us. Lead on. I'm behind you.
Bump and grind, Gore. Some hip-hop, buddy. Wait, no, where are you going? Gore, where are you going? Throw in some hip-hop. All right, I'll do it. Done anything yet, it's already a gold stream. Honestly, I worry that nothing else can possibly happen that will ever top this in this entire playthrough. I legitimately worry about this.
Lead on. Behind you.
On a completely other note, I bought an entire like package of strawberries at the start of this week and they are already molded. I am upset. I am pretty fucking pissed.
Actions. This has to be it. Dismiss, but hang out here. Is that okay? Okay. Did he just...
Did he just...
He did.
Alright, Gore. Give me some sugar before I leave you here forever.